Hi, my name is Michael Nunez. I'm a district sales agent with Transworld Systems. After watching this short video, if you'd like to contact me, my cell phone and my email are right here at the beginning of the recording on this slide in the PowerPoint. So hopefully I'll hear from you. If you see this, logically speaking, there's no reason why anybody wouldn't want to talk to me about how we get these results. But let's talk a little bit about the service that we provide and our collection program for 20,000 healthcare clients to use us. We have interfaces with athenahealth, Centricity, ECW, Greenway. Those are probably the four prominent ones, but we also have interfaces with, you know, pathology division with Change Healthcare, formerly known as McKesson, and embedded interfaces with Mac Practice, MicroMD, NextGen, and others. So if you're not using one of these software programs, that's okay. We can build a large client interface for the larger volume clients. And we also have a web portal that some of our smaller practices can use to upload Excel or manually key in accounts if their volume's that small. So let's look at the revenue cycle and how Transworld categorizes, you will, debt into four different categories. We look at patient debt as four sections: dutiful, distracted, disrespectful, and then deliberate. Now, your dutiful patients, regardless of what your specialty is the patients that pay on time. These are the ones that get the first bill, they pay, they call, they make arrangements, they're doing something actively to take care of that debt. These are the best patients to have. 80% on an average for an average practice is probably the amount of accounts that fall into that category. Some could be lower, depending on the specialty and demographic. The ones that don't respond kind of categorize themselves as distracted patients, right? They're going through health issues that could be causing that distraction. That could be why they're visiting you in the first place. They could be going through divorces. They could go through job loss. They could be moving. There's a lot of things that can actually distract a patient from taking care of the bill. And unfortunately, they look at medical bills as the bottom of the totem pole when it comes to responsibility of paying bills. They got to pay the rent, the car, the gas, the electric, the phone, utilities, the groceries, and then whatever's left, the non-priority bills, you know, might get some attention. But we have a program called Accelerator that over 20,000 medical clients use that accelerates the first-party contacts in the client's name. So I want to stress, these are all in our client's name. So it's a letter from our client that's passed through with a phone call, a voucher, and an envelope for them to pay. We can also add a payment website here, an automated phone call, which is TCPA compliant, so we manually dial it if it's a cell phone. 7 days later, another pass-through contact. 7 days later, a fourth, and 7 days later, a fifth. So in less than a month, that patient's being reminded five times between 60 and 90 days, or it could be between 90 and 120, depending on when the client plugs it in, to call, to pay, to do something. The results are phenomenal. We'll look at that in just a minute. The next stage is profit recovery, and this is the staple of what Transworld's been doing since 1970. It's a third-party demand series, so I like to refer to this as pre-collection, early out, soft collections, whatever you want to call it, where the patient's getting a series of five demands for payment over a 10-day interval, still instructing them to call and pay you. And as your phone number on all five contacts, just like an accelerator, vouchers on 1, 3, and 5 with envelopes to send you the payment. Payment websites, again, can be added on here as well. And there's also a thank you letter in this stage that goes out to accounts that pay in full. And it lets them know that our client has requested that we thank them and that you appreciate their business and welcome them back in the future. So that repeat business from patients is important for most of our medical clients. And then the last stage is Transworld Collections, which is where we do have telephone divisions that get on the phone and call patients. All the calls in this division are recorded for compliance. We take the approach of you catch more flies with sugar than you do with vinegar in this stage. And if you have another agency that you're locked in with, you know, for whatever reason, and you want to keep them, that's fine. But you can use Accelerator and Profit Recovery, and in many cases with an interface that gets 40, 50, sometimes 60% of these patients to respond that you don't have to give to that collection agency. So a lot of money coming in for a very little fee, very small fee, if you will, and it increases cash flow, reduces the days outstanding, and it doesn't matter if it's a hospital or a single doctor practice, this program works for all of them. We're going to look at that. So let's look at some results and see how clients invest in that flat fee per account, how Transworld gets paid for that service. Now, this is an oncology client in New Mexico. We blocked out the names on all of these reports, so we're not allowed to show them for compliance reasons, of course. But this oncology clinic actually switched from Transworld at one point, tried another agency in New Mexico that, you know, promised them the world. And in a very short order, in about 6 months, they called us back and said, hey, we made a mistake. We need to get signed back up again. And they've been a client for 10 years since then, and they have not switched. Their fee is $9.87 per account for profit recovery, which is the second stage. It's the five letters from Transworld. They have submitted 4,037 accounts. Their average balance is $500. And again, diplomacy is paramount, right, in this market. They submit accounts after 4 months, excuse me, so after 120 days, they've billed this client four or five times, they've called them, they obviously are, you know, one of those distracted or deliberate debtors that they're the ones that are getting submitted. Out of the 2 million submitted, 926,000 has either paid in full, made arrangements, or, you know, made a partial payment, but the contacts kept going. That's 47% of the money. 59% of the accounts responding. That's almost a 60% recovery rate. That's unheard of in medical. Unheard of. 4.3% is their collection cost. So if we were charging this oncology clinic a percentage, which we're not, it would be 4.3%. So if you're paying a percentage to an agency at any point, why you wouldn't want to look at this service would be beyond me. $39,000 investment to get back almost $1 million, which is a 4.3% collection cost. A 33% agency would have charged them $308,000 to do what we did for $39,000 if that agency collected this much money. They're not. The telephone does not work anymore. That way of collecting is ancient history, and it gets very little results even in our collection division. So these pre-collection tools and these early out tools are phenomenal resources to get patients paying. Now let's look at the next one. This is a sleep center client of mine in Texas and New Mexico. $318 is their average balance, $10.64. They actually just upload an Excel to us monthly with the accounts they want to submit. They're submitted between 90 and 120. This is Accelerator. So this is the five contacts from them, not Transworld Systems. 580,000 submitted, 260,000 paid, called, made arrangements, made a partial payment, but the letters kept going out or the phone calls kept going out in Accelerator. That's 61% of the accounts that responded after 90 days. Their in-house recovery prior to plugging this in between 90 and 120 was less than 15%. Think about that. They've gone from a 15% recovery between 90 and 120 to 61%. Like flipping on a light switch. $19,000 investment based on the flat fee per account of about $10.64 to get back $260,000, which is a collection cost of 7.4% that didn't have to go to collections. That's a pretty good return on investment as well, as you can see here at the bottom. Same client uses the second stage after Accelerator. So again, flat fee per account, $358,000 submitted, a lot less money going to pre-collections because of Accelerator, which is what the doctor wants. $111,000 responding, 32% of the money, another 47% recovery of the accounts. That's just amazing considering these accounts are now 6 months old, right? $9,600 investment to get back $111,000, which if compared to a collection agency, we charge them a percentage, would be 8.7%, not 30, not 40, not 50, 8%. All of that money is paying our clients directly. ROI of 1151 to 1. Now, the last one here is an extremely large client, one of my largest clients. It's a neuroscience client in Arizona. They have huge volume. We have an interface with ECW, which they love. Their fee is $9 per account. The average balance is $246. So again, we're not talking about huge balances here, but high volume. Average age is 4 months old when they put them into Accelerator. So again, Accelerator is the first party contacts. They have a central billing office with about 10, 11 employees in there. They do a great job internally, but if they get to 120, they put them in, they have the interface set up with ECW where they put them into Transworld, into this accelerator portion. Out of 3.8 million submitted, they've recovered 2.1, which is 70% of the patients responding after 4 months old. I mean, that's crazy. This is still first-party contacts. They don't even know who Transworld is. $139,000 investment to get back 2.1 million, which is a collection cost of 6.6%. There's not a CFO in the country that wouldn't do anything, probably chew off their left arm to give those kind of results before they give them to collections. That's an ROI of $15 to one. And yes, they use the second stage, which is the pre-collection, and even our collection division is the last resort. But in this stage, again, it's early out, pre-collection, it's demands from Transworld without a phone call ever being made. They're about 6 months old at this point. 4,100 have been submitted to this stage for 1.2 million. 265,000 collected, which is a 30% recovery rate of the accounts after 6 months old, and a collection cost of $37,000 to get that 265, which would be 14% cost. Again, that's crazy compared to what percentage agencies do. And then the money we collect for this client from the collection division, it's found money. That's why, you know, they're happy to not send that much to the collection division. So if you'd like more information, I hope to hear from you soon. Have a great day.